Thanks to CuriosityStream for supporting my channel. Get access to the extended version of this video when you sign up for CuriosityStream and Nebula using the link in the description. If you've ever played a video game, you'll know that the path to victory is non-linear. You'll have to learn new moves, adjust to increasing difficulty levels, and learn new skills, with rewards being few and far between. What am I talking about? I haven't played a video game since I had a Wii when I was like 12. But you get the point. What you might not know, and what is more important for this video, is that reinforcement learning algorithms face similar challenges when trying to win simulated video games. And unfortunately for them, they don't have save locations. And if you need a refresher on reinforcement learning, I will leave a link in the description and a card up top to a video that I did on it a while back. But in short, reinforcement learning focuses on models that solve complex problems requiring sequential decision-making steps. In other words, problems that require you to take several actions before you would receive a reward. And we've talked about some of these models before, models like DeepMind's AlphaGo, which can beat some of the world's greatest Go players, as well as OpenAI's Dota 2 system. And reinforcement learning models learn by exploring a problem space, which can mean anything from playing a game of Go against itself hundreds to millions of times in order to figure out what the best moves are in every possible situation, to attempting to pick up and hold and solve a Rubik's Cube without dropping it or solving it incorrectly as OpenAI did. In short, it focuses on finding the best sequence of decisions that lead to the highest reward or the final reward. And herein lies the problem. Actually, two problems. And a recent Nature paper from Uber AI Labs and OpenAI claims to have made some headway on both. But let's talk about the problems first. There's a lot of names in the literature for these types of problems, but for the purposes of this video, we're going to call them sparsity and deception. In this case, sparsity refers to sparsity of rewards, or problems where a reinforcement learning model will only occasionally receive rewards, and it will typically take many, many steps for it to receive it. And this is a problem because reinforcement learning models are designed to optimize exploration and exploitation. That is, optimize exploration of the space of possible decision sequences to lead to a reward, and exploit past decisions that have led to rewards already. Sparsity means that it's going to be very difficult for a model to find that final reward in the first place and may instead end up at a dead end. Deception refers to scenarios where a model is given feedback that actually points it in the wrong direction, such as those smaller local rewards that might tell a model that it's on the right track, when in fact it might actually be going in the wrong direction. The paper in question focuses on a model called Go Explore, which interestingly names their two solutions to our two problems, and looks at the performance of this model against the arcade learning environment, which includes 55 games from Atari 2600. That includes fan favorites like Mrs. Pac-Man, Gopher, and Asteroids, none of which I think I've actually played. And in this paper, they refer to our two problems as detachment, where a model doesn't make it far enough down a sequence of steps to receive a reward, and derailment, where the design of the algorithm prevents it from returning to previous solutions that may lead to the best overall path to the final reward. The Go of Go Explore handles derailment by creating an archive of all of the states that the algorithm has been in and the associated rewards. On the other hand, the Explore of Go Explore handles detachment by allowing the model to explore a particular state that was associated with a certain reward. These combined approaches allow an algorithm to explore states that were successful in the past so that once we're done exploring the new states that we've discovered from there, we can update our archive with all these new states and their associated rewards and jump back to a state that we know has a good reward. With this approach, Go Explore was able to achieve superhuman performance on all 55 of the games in the arcade learning environment, although that's based on the average human performance on these games, so I don't actually know if that's very good. But Go Explore also does surpass our current state-of-the-art machine learning result on 11 of the 55 games as well. And interestingly, throughout all of this, we haven't given our model domain knowledge, so we haven't told our model anything specific about the games other than things like the rules or things like physical constraints for the robot, so it's learning how to interact with these spaces by itself. Now, there's one important catch to all of this, and that's that Go Explore relies on restorable environments. In other words, we need to have simulations that we can recreate at will so that our models can explore those spaces again in order for this to work. So when we look at challenges like video games or simulated robots, Go Explore works really well because we can always jump back to an earlier state or a state that the model has not explored yet. But for real life or real time challenges, we can't. For example, if we wanted to use this method to train an autonomous driving system, We could create every possible simulation that we think a car would ever run into, and chances are within the first hour or so of driving on the real road, the car would run into a simulation that the model had not encountered yet. However, this isn't to say that this approach isn't useful. In fact, it might be a great way of pre-training models more efficiently. So instead of having to train an autonomous car fully on the road, we could pre-train an algorithm based on a simulated environment and then put it on the road for the fine-tuning, and then deploy these models in real-world environments with some safety constraints and improve them in real time. In the interest of time, I'm gonna stop here, but I actually go into a deeper dive on how this model works and how you can try to play with it yourself in the extended Nebula Plus version of this video. If you're new to my channel, Nebula is a creator-built platform where you get to watch my videos ad-free, and me and some other creators that you've probably heard of can create and experiment with awesome content without having to worry about demonetization or paying tribute to the YouTube algorithm. We're thrilled to be partnering with CuriosityStream, a subscription streaming service with thousands of documentaries and nonfiction videos. Want to learn more about the mathematics of success? Check out The Joy of Winning, where mathematician Hannah Fry helps us understand how we can use math to get more of what we want out of our lives. And where CuriosityStream is all about big budget nonfiction documentaries, we're building Nebula so that education-y creators have a place to test out content that might not work on YouTube. On Nebula, you'll find ad-free videos from some of your favorite creators, from Tier 2 to Neurotransmissions to The Coding Train, and my Nebula Plus content, which includes journal clubs of interesting papers and extended versions of the videos that you see on my channel. You'll also find Nebula originals like Tom Scott's Game Show Money or A Very Good Trivia Show, where Sam from Wendover challenges myself, Real Engineering, and City Beautiful to a bunch of interesting and a bit bizarre challenges, and where I win $500 for drawing a really nice circle. CuriosityStream loves independent creators and wants to help us grow our platform, so if you click on the link in the description or use my promo code Jordan, you can get access to CuriosityStream for 26% off their annual plans, with Nebula included for free as long as you are a CuriosityStream member. That's less than $15 a year. Signing up for CuriosityStream and Nebula is a great way to directly support my channel while getting to watch my videos ad-free, so sign up for CuriosityStream and Nebula at curiositystream.com/Jordan or using the promo code Jordan. Otherwise, if you like this video, you can let me know by smashing the like button and subscribing to my channel. You can also check out the video that I did on deploying AlphaGo onto a Raspberry Pi, which was a very interesting project. I'm hoping to do more Raspberry Pi work in the future, so if that sounds interesting to you, you can let me know in the comments. Otherwise, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram, and I will see you on Monday. Bye.